Hello, dear medicos. We are having the honor to have Dr. Shaunak with us, rank All India rank 16, our DAMS Pune Foundation student. So on the behalf of DAMS family, beta, we congrats you for such a nice achievement.
Thank you.
After such a great, awesome rank of 16, what is your feeling now?
Well, firstly, I'm feeling relieved, and then I'm also feeling exhilarated that I was a part of the DAMS club. I was able to attend DAMS class, and because of them, I would have got such a good rank.
That's great. So, beta, before this interview, you were telling me that today is your parents' wedding anniversary.
Yeah.
So, we will dedicate this session to your parents. So, just any special message for them, beta, before starting
this? I just like to say that I hope this was a good gift which I was able to give you, and I will continue to give you better gifts in the future.
Yeah,
thank you.
Absolutely. You will be, definitely. So, beta, Dr. Shaunak, he joined us in DAMS Pune Foundation batch third year. So, how was your experience with our gold standard classroom learning?
Well, it has been a very surreal experience since the class which started in third minor. We had multiple sessions in third minor, and we had a repeat session of the same subjects in third major. So I think all the subjects have been covered in good detail, and I was able to use these notes for revision in my internship.
So in the third year, you attended how many subjects? Like in third year, what was your strategy?
Actually, when the class started, our first session was physio, which I unfortunately had missed because of a trip.
Okay.
But after that, I decided on all the other sessions, so I have missed only physio and surgery one lecture. Otherwise, I have attended all the lectures.
So yeah. You made your standard notes in the third year itself.
Yes.
So how you handle, like, your college pressure was there, then you were coming on the weekend classes of all sitting there. So how you manage all this pressure in the third year itself?
Many times you have to make a choice between attending college sometimes for certain postings and attending class. If you can adjust, I think you should try towards attending class, because if you have your own written set of notes, it's always helpful compared to borrowing from a friend or getting printed notes, which are available. But I'll always suggest that you should have your own set of notes. Only then you can understand what you have
written
about everything.
One thing we are learning from you, okay, we should write our own notes rather than taking from somebody else.
Yes.
So sitting in the classroom in the DAMS Pune and you're getting a rank all in the rank 16. So I think in DAMS Pune, you must, being a foundation, you must have attended this session two times.
Yeah.
So how was your experience, and finally you attended TND, test and discussion, in the internship?
I had tried attending TND, but because of the pressures of internship, I was not able to do it that well.
Okay.
So unfortunately, I did not attend a lot of TNDs.
Lots of TNDs.
I think it would have been more helpful for me if I could have managed to attend them.
So gold standard class notes, which you have written in the third year.
Yeah.
So you just revised those notes in the final year in the internship?
Yes. So I did not have a well set plan that I'm going to do these subjects in this time, because I'm a very anxious person. So if I make an extremely rigid timetable, it gives me more tension. I will not end up studying. So I had a loose idea about which subjects I want to do when. One strategy which I used was, whatever posting is going on, I used to do those subjects.
Okay.
So at least I used to see clinically what is the relevance of
so
that.
So you don't miss any clinical learning at the college itself.
Yeah.
That is a current pattern which you must have appreciated in the last NEET exam.
But then I had to make time for the subjects for which I don't have clinical postings. That is the first and the second year subjects, which are very important.
Okay. So if, like, being a foundation student, you managed to get rank 16 in all India. So if I ask you opportunity, which three subjects or four subjects are very crucial for the game changer?
Game changer, according to me, I think my second year subjects were very strong. So I used to love doing pharmac, microbio, as well as patho. And you need to have a good knowledge in these particular subjects for you to understand the basic concepts of your third major subjects.
Okay.
So if you don't do these subjects properly, it will be difficult for you.
Second year subjects, we can say that they are the first line of batsmen we should focus on.
Yeah, true. And then obviously, according to the marks which have been allotted to each subject, which was not followed in this exam, unfortunately.
It was a typical exam.
So those subjects also become important. Something like PSM, gynecology are obviously important subjects. Medicine and surgery, I was very scared about them because I did not know what to read and how much to read, how less to read. And I did manage to read some amount of medicine and surgery before preparing, but I felt the yield was relatively low compared to doing second year subjects really well.
So we can say more weightage on the second year subject.
Yeah.
Now coming on the last NEET, we have seen in OBGY, in the PSM, the focus was more MCQs were there.
Yeah.
So how you handle these two subjects? I'm coming one by one on the subjects because everybody is looking on you as a motivation.
So regarding PSM, I think many people don't like that subject. It is difficult to read first hand, at least from PACS. But the way it was covered in class, especially the second time, first time we had focused more on biostats in our third minor. Third major, they had focused more on infectious diseases and programs. And program is something which keeps on changing. So you have to pay attention to what is happening and what is being asked. So in our in our something which people don't usually do, like a non-communicable disease. So questions had come from that, something like Monica. Monica was a question which was asked in NEET, which is something which people don't do. And it was covered in class, so I'm happy that I was able to answer that one question because of class.
You, all the unusual MCQs which were there in the NEET were covered in the classroom itself. Yeah. So you can say in the new final and old final, you are blessed through the part of Dams Pune, where they are organizing all the classes in a very systematic way.
Yes.
You get the opportunity to attend PSM two times, and this complete notes for the more than sufficient for your needs.
Yeah, because two times two different teachers, so you get two different approaches towards a particular subject. That is very helpful. You have two sets of notes. Some people say two sets of notes is difficult to do, so you can read them simultaneously. It's not
what I'm getting from your words, K, you should not go for the comfort zone. If you are getting two different type of notes from two faculties of DAMS, so you should go and you should not follow any shortcut.
Yes,
that's
true.
That's great. And being a third year student, many students must be asking, okay, if attending the lectures and all these classes, and that too again two times in the third year final year, okay, did it affect your prof or it was a supplementary in your prof exams?
It was supplementary, like for first and second year subjects. First year, I was not able to read. When I was in first year, I had left certain aspects, important aspects of anatomy, physiology, which I got to revise because of the term. And one more very important use which I find for these lectures is there are many quizzes which are being conducted in colleges. Yeah. In BJ, I was in BJ, Pune, as well as other colleges. So if you read these notes, they are important preparatory material for the quiz also. And just when you are preparing for the quiz, you are might as well preparing for the exam. If you can, like undergraduate students should participate in more quizzes. It's very helpful.
Like if you're starting from the third year and like now the, if they plan the next exam in the final year itself, the preparation should be somewhere early, planning should be there in the second year.
Yes, and even if you're not planning for the next exam, you should have some short-term goals, some quiz, some exam in college, some term ending.
Notes helps a lot in those quizzes and all those things.
Especially like Pharmac, I used to read the notes. I used to answer a lot of questions from Pharmac from the notes. Because pre-Pharmac subjects lean a lot on Pharmac questions, especially in quizzes. So I used to find that very helpful.
That's great. That's where we are having proud moment to have Dr. Shanak with us, ranked 16 All India. And that's true. I will highlight this point being an intern student. Because as a intern, many students give an excuse that internship is hectic. I will prepare after my completion. So what do you feel like you are getting this?
According to my opinion, the best attempt you can give is during internship. Because internship, I know it is very hectic. No one likes doing it. Actually, I did like doing it. It provides you some form of distractions. You need some distraction. You can't just sit and study full day. You, if you go in the hospital, you work, you do some nominal jobs to some amount for some time, it makes you relax. Like you can obviously relax by other ways, but I think this was helpful for me.
Helpful. Like in the post-internship, you will be under big pressure. Yeah. If I compare with the internship, at least everybody is going to the internship and all the clinics. So it will be a change in your mind and you get relaxed.
Yeah, and one more thing is you get to go to college, you get to interact with people who are simultaneously preparing for the exam. It creates some sort of a stressor as well as some sort of comfort that you are not the only person who is studying.
Agreed. So same thing I will be discussing, like you were sitting in the DAMS Pune classroom. I still remember the auditorium. You are having the best auditorium of the country.
Yeah.
You can say proud thing we are having in DAMS Pune. So what do you say? All the peer pressure, all the students sitting with you were creating a stress or there was a motivation from them?
No, I would like to call it eustress. It is stress as well as motivation. You need some amount of stress to be motivated. And ma'am had said, Niti ma'am, she had taking DVT, she had said, ki, you just don't need motivation, you need to have discipline. So if you have discipline, motivation dies at some point of time. But if you have discipline, it will be very helpful.
That is very practically possible in the classroom, learning this thing. So I can get from your words, ki, you had done hard effort in the third year, final year.
Yeah.
And you built up all the class notes.
Yeah.
And in the internship, you just go through those revision of the class notes.
Yeah, and one more thing which I used to do was, I used to study with my juniors, who were posted in second year and third year. So I'd like to thank them.
Are you are giving the best methodology of learning. You should teach somebody.
I learned that. It's called as the Feynman technique. So I used to sit in my college outside the library, and I used to find anyone who wanted to study with me. I used to study with them.
That's good.
That is something which I enjoy doing.
So you motivate our juniors for the group study.
If you're studying, if it's a group study, you should study.
Your condition, applied conditions are very nice. Yes, if you are studying, it should be only studying. That's it. So after getting all these class notes in with the TND notes and you are revising, how many times revised you these class notes?
Okay, so from what I had spoken to my seniors and my sister is 2 years senior to me. So they had told me that you are supposed to finish reading the first revision by August. Because of some reason or the other, it was not possible for me because I read very slowly. Like I can't do multiple revisions. I do slow revisions.
Okay.
So it was not possible to finish it by August. It was lasting till September and extending even beyond September. So then I decided that it's fine if I have not finished first unit of some subjects, I will start revising certain subjects to reduce its stress, and that helped me.
So first revision we can say till the August. Yeah. And what we say as a part of DAMS family, everybody promise. Sorry. In DVT we go for one revision.
Yeah.
So somewhere between the August and the DVT, how you manage the notes and MCQs?
I think it is very, very helpful if you are able to finish at least one revision before DVT. And okay. You have already started a re-revision of some subjects which you are comfortable with. So that will be very helpful for you to DVT, because when the DVT is going on, it is actually very fast. So you have to pay attention to what is going on, and you have to...
Before that, you should revise
the things. Yeah, yeah. And you should say the answers out, even if not out loud, at least in your mind, that you know that what is being taught.
That is the best way of learning. Before going for DVT, you should have minimum one or maximum two revisions, so that you can...
It is not possible for me, okay. But still.
Being an intern, I say, yeah, it was difficult for two revisions before DVT. So now when you appeared for the DVT, and those 3 days of very, you can say, every faculty was trying to give the best performance and best stuff. So how you get that motivation from those 3 days, how fast revision is possible?
DVT helped me I'll tell you how it helped me. After doing my revision, one and two revisions, from some subjects I was able to do two revisions. Then 5 days, 5 or 10 days were left for the exam. So it is not possible for me to sit and read all 19 subjects once again. So I had to do something which was short. So DAMS had already uploaded all the DVT videos, condensed version of DVT videos on the eMedicos website. So I used to see the 15 minutes videos, and then I used to do whatever I felt was important. Obviously, what was being mentioned in those videos, plus the important thing which I felt can be asked from there. And only because of this, I was able to do 1 day, 1 year. So, 1 day I did first year subject, second I did second year subject, third day,
One day, first year subject. Yeah. Was second it possible? I want everybody should listen these words. He managed to revise first year subjects. I think many students will be shocked by listening this statement. But your rank proved this thing. Yeah. You revise first year subjects in 1 day, but that was only possible.
Yeah, but that is DVT. Yeah, DVT material.
After DVT material, but that was possible only when you were taking efforts since third year.
Yeah,
like you're directly entering in the internship and you attend DVT and then you start revising. Not practically possible.
No.
It means hard effort. Two divisions followed by DVT, you can manage 1 year subject. This is a task we give to our students in the last month or last 1.5 months. If you can manage to revise one subject 1 day, so you will be on the top.
Yeah.
And you are saying you are completing the whole first year subject basic points.
Yeah, that was like just 3 or 5 days before the exam, because then there is so much to read and then you get confused, you get scared. So it is better to have some plan, pre-decided plan, that I'm going to do 5 days. 5 subjects. I'm just going to look at DVT videos and little points which I feel important from each subject.
You add in the points. That's it. So after attending all these DAMS class notes, how you handle this DQB, DAMS question bank?
I used to solve whatever I could. Like
how many MCQs? Like everybody must be asking, how many MCQs?
Questions you solve at the end of the day, you should have at least reviewed those questions. Okay. I'm not saying you have to take a notebook and write down whatever you felt was new.
Mm-hmm.
Only the thing which is utmost important, a new concept that you have learned, only that should be added to your notes.
Okay.
You don't need to add each and every MCQ that you don't know.
Okay,
because then you're creating a parallel set of notes. So how many set of notes are you going to create? You should read only that much that you're going to
one
revise.
One source should be there. Okay, you should stuck to one source and you should revise it.
So whatever that source may be, just ensure that you're sticking to it. And you're not creating excess notes and excess information, because that scares me
Everybody. Like everybody now 2020, everybody is going for the multiple sources, because we have many online options are there. But what we feel key to success is your one source, multiple time revision. Coming back on the grand test, like you attempted all the grand test and subject to SWT, how was the experience MCQs in grand test followed by SWT followed by CBT? You appeared for all the 4 CBT?
I attempted the three CBTs. The first CBT I did not attempt. Okay. I attempted the last 3 CBTs.
So how was your experience of GT subject wise and CBT?
The main reason why I gave the CBTs especially was I wanted to be familiar with the environment.
Okay.
So the best thing which you can do before preparing for NEET, no matter how much you study, is you have to be familiar with the exam environment. It has to be a regular thing for you to give 3.5 hour tests. No matter from where you are giving the test, but you should be giving that test. You should have the ability to sit for 3.5 hours without your mind deviating somewhere else, that you are solving a test. You need to have that much. So if you do that well enough, on the day of the main exam, that is NEET, it should be a feeling that you are just giving another test. You should forget the fact that you're giving NEET so that you will be able to focus on questions better. That was what I did, and it worked fortunately for me during the exam. Like, so I forgot I was giving the main exam and I was just solving the paper.
So level of the MCQs that was covered in Grand Test and CBT, and how you compare those MCQs with the level of the last
year? Yeah, especially about CBT, I was kind of shocked after my last CBT result. I got a rank of 2000. Okay. In my CBT 2 and CBT 3, my ranks were two digit ranks. I had got 26 rank in CBT 2 and 70 rank in CBT 3. So I was pretty confident. Theek, I'm going well. But then I got a very bad shock that I got a rank of 2000. I noticed, like, not right thing to say, but it was thoda sa disturbing for me. So I got scared, what am I going to do? But still, I managed to maintain my calm and I continued studying. I did not stop studying, I did not get demotivated, and I continued studying. So that helped out.
So coming in the NEET exam, how many MCQs you attempted?
I attempted 290. I hope 290. That is not a lot.
290. But yeah, in the exam, which was on the little bit difficult side, 290 was a good number. You have attempted. That's great. So coming on the next spell, like, after you are a part of our DAMS family for the last 3 years and a proud foundation student from DAMS Pune, rank All India 16. So if which faculties, like the whole DAMS family, is trying best to motivate the student in the stressful time? So what do you feel? Which faculties motivate you max?
The faculty which motivate me max was Deepti ma'am. I really liked her lecture and the way she delivered it. Mm-hmm. And she used to always say, they were her words that she had said, that motivation dies, but it is discipline which is helpful. And I am a firm believer of this point. That it is not just motivation which is helpful for you. Then Sumeya sir, of course. Then I also like to thank Anupama ma'am. She is a physio faculty, as well as Sharma sir from Pune. Because he was the one who used to organize all the lectures for us.
Hats off to him. Okay, for at this age, he's just taking so much effort for all the Pune students. So just we thanks him on this platform for taking so much efforts. And coming on the last spell, which any special message you want to deliver to your juniors?
I just want to discuss one thing. Like, I've never repeated, so I can't tell repeaters what to do or what not to do. Because I was a fresher, I would like to tell people who are currently starting their internship or people who are in their second year, third year, that it should be a norm that you should be studying properly during internship and getting the seat in first attempt, because it will be very easy. I think it's very difficult. It's extremely commendable that people who have not got anything in first attempt, say second attempt or third attempt, are still trying, because it is not up to me to. I don't have that much patience. It is very difficult for me to do it, and I admire the people who are doing it.
Very, very golden words. You are saying the maximum chance of getting rank is in the internship.
So everyone should attempt towards that.
Thanks a lot for coming on this platform and sharing your motivation to everybody. Thanks. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.